university, where in a laboratory when we do mainly social analysis data. And what I want to talk here, it's about the opening data in France, and more specifically about the civic data and what we do with it from different point of view, maybe to giving inspiration for people. And feel free to stop me if I talk badly. I can
put that in your pocket.
Okay.
Sorry, it's making me nervous.
No. And so on. I want to take multiple point of view. The first will be from a government point of view, the second from a crowd point of view, then community, and lastly, science. So the government-driven governments have put a website called data.gov.fr where they put a lot of data. And they gather them from different institutions, and they have some responsibility in front of the law to do this. So the first thing, how they organize them, they see three types of actors. There is the producer, the people who produce the data. They get the demand from the user, and they have the obligation to redirect them from the good data sets. They engage themselves to produce data quality with regularity. And finally, they choose who will be the broadcaster. So the broadcaster are mainly the people who need to communicate with the public, with a large public, to put the data on website, for example. And they have the responsibility to make good scalability and 100% high level access. It's very important because everyone needs to access to this data, and they are, by the law, they need to do this. And lastly, there is a user, and the user also have a legal statute because they can create new service. And with this new service, the government's friends hope it will create economic values. And also, finally, the user has the possibility to warn producer about errors in data or lacks. So, example, we can see the national addresses databases where all the addresses is cartographed and put it in a geo context, and well, I cannot zoom. Maybe I could do this. Whoa. Yes. So, what we can see on the photography is. They need to put metadata associated to, like in which license we are, in when the database is gathered, and how many times. And they have the obligation to cite which institution are involved of the data gathering. For example, there is La Poste in French, creo que en español es correo, the mail postal in English, and other actors like IGN, Institute of National Geographics, and they work together to put the data. Well, there are main producers, so I just see the national bus's address. There is a lot of actors. I don't want you to remember this, but what I want to show it is there is also the Prime Minister and the Minister of the Interior who are involved in this process. It's very important because it's not totally free. Maybe they can have a certain vision of the data they put and so on. This is why I say it is a government point of view. So we can fund like fields like farming and foods, culture, economic, jobs, education, international, housing, health and social, society, transport, etc. But it's important to know all of this is not gathered equally. Another example, it is data about pesticides. So we have a map where we can see the level of pesticide in the France, because it is a country where there is a lot of farming, and there is a map where we the water is regularly tested, and there is a warning level about the water quality. It could be really useful for the farming people, but also for the citizens in some villages who are involved against some company or thing like that, you know.
So that's based on water testing or also soil testing?
I don't know all of the data, because there is a lot of data, but for what I remember, it is for on a water testing and in underground water testing, mm-hmm. You know. And I think even there is an institution involved in, but I don't remember the name. But each time or each data on datagov.fr is referenced, so you can find which institution is involved in. So now I want to talk about an experience, sort of experiences of crowd driving. It's called republicnumeric.fr. It was fixed by a legal framework to create another law. For them, they create a website before the law was voted, and the main goal of this website was to gather proposition about it, and more specifically, gather from proposition from net citizen, if I can say that. There is multiple steps. So the first one will be to consult the people on the internet. Then they they organize between how much people vote and which was the proposition who was the most voted. They make conclusion about it. They send this conclusion to the government. The government responds what he wants, what he don't want. And then finally, there is a vote in the National Assembly about a mixed project of some law taken from the government and some proposition of law taken from internet. It was the first time the France do that, and it was a really interesting experience. So there is more than 2,100 people who has active registered users. I call this net citizen. It's not exactly the words, but anyway. And there is multiple law proposition, more than 500, specifically related to law proposition. And there is also proposition of argument or law amendment, more than 8,500. And so on, there is 1,500. Sorry, I don't know exactly my number in English, but you can read it. Of votes of people who vote and give their review. So, if I zoom again, we can see. Watch, look the website. For example, this is on chapter one, first section. Economy about the data, and this subject was talk about the opening of the public data, and specifically, if I remember, about opening also the algorithm used in institution, because it's really important. So the funny thing here is maybe the little charts where you can see positive vote, negative vote, and neutral vote. And the number of votes, the number of modification of the text, the number of arguments, the number of sources, if it is related to a whole law, and maybe to science reports, which could be useful. So there is a lot of proposition. I'm not here to explain which of all of us. I just want to show how it could be represent a law who will be vote on the internet. Not really vote on the internet, but construct from the internet in a part. Well, did you understand me very well? I speak English very badly.
Yes.
Okay.
Very French accent.
Thank you. Hall was not perfect on this crowd driven, but at least the public debate is now open and reinforced. One of the proposition, for example, talk about net neutrality, and it was refused in parts, and well, it created debates, and now the government had said, well, next year we will talk more about it because we saw there is a lot of people involved of this. And another bad things, I think, it's the abrogation of criminalizing cryptography was refused, because in France it's partially criminalized to encrypt your data.
Wait, can you say that again?
In French, it was partially criminalizing to cryptography your data.
So if you encrypted your data.
Yes,
it could be.
Yes, you need to register if you want to get the authorization. You could do personally in a sense, but if you are a company, you cannot do without registered and giving a copy of your keys. It depends on some subjects. But behind the law, if one day you are in trouble, you have the obligation of giving your data, or you risk a lot. But other things are good, like the opening of public algorithm. When the students start to choose the university, there is an algorithm who is used to choose which student will go to the university related to their first three choice. And this algorithm was not known before this law. So before that, it entirely depends of the education national education minister, and no one knows how this was done. So now we have obligated the national education to share the algorithm. And it was funny because the first time they just shared an SQL script, and it means nothing. You know, there is not documentation, there is not metadata associated. So it's the start of a process about opening algorithm and what it depends on. Also, an interesting theme, it's now with this crowd law project, video game competition is officially recognized by government, and you can now make a video game competition like a sport, like an e-sport. Mm-hmm. It has an official statute, and I think it could be interesting to Cuban people because I think they have a SNET. Something like that, make me correct if I'm...
No.
You have a video game competition, I think, no?
Here yes. There is even an association. Association. I cannot remember the name.
On Dota and things like that, okay. So that's good because in the entire world, the video game competition is rising.
Yes, I cannot remember exactly the name, but it's something like electronic sports.
SNET? isn't it? People take me about that. Isn't it? Yes? Okay. So with this law now, for the government, maybe it's not an important subject. It seems to be funny for him, childly, but well, this is maybe a victory for young people like me who like to play. So that's a good thing. Another good point, it's the open access of science article, where the time elapsed before you can open access to your article is reduced. And it's better because now the science move on really speedily. So before that, you need to wait some years, 1 or 2 years, if I remember, if you publish an article and you are and your institution don't want you to share the information. And now the time is reduced to some months. So if you're a researcher, it could be good for you because you are not enchained, blocked by the institution which with you worked. Another interesting thing, it is community driven. There is an association who's called regardcitoyen.org who make reports about the national data in the assembly or in the senators and deputies. And you can see, for example, on their website, the lastly activity parliamentary about the 4 last months. You can see in different color the different political party who was involved in the activity parliamentary in the senatory and national assembly. So in the last months, we can see, for example, one of the party called En Marche. It's the actual party of the French president, President Macron. And it was one of the most who talk the most currently. There is different type of data they get, like rated question, proposition, amendments, intervention on speaking, and presence of the deputy. They fixed themselves 3 goals to share the data and their conclusion about it. They produce data and they gather them under free licenses because on data.gov.fr, the licenses is not always really clear and it appears to change more or less regularly. It depends. It's not really clear. And they want to do free data, of course, and also open formats with documentation and associated metadata. Well, and they get different websites like specifically for deputy, for senators, for parliamentary activity, and for local finances in the little in the city of France. For example, you can find your deputy in your city or in your geography area. And what we can see here, it is a presences, a participation, spoken question, and her holidays, because, well, they stay humans and they have the right to take holidays. And the median of the participation of all the people. What we can see, it is this guy called Alain Touré. It is a deputy from En Marche, and it in the area geographics of the Calvados. And I don't know if you see very well, but we saw the median here, and it is clearly under the median. So it is not someone who is really here. It is not someone who participates a lot. And well, if you want, you can call him. Ah, we don't see, but there is all this communication information, there is all this credential, and all the project law he votes or not, and all these things he do or he don't do. It permit to make watching and surveillances about your deputy and senator, and in the finances local, who is not covered by government access data. So it is an association who try to gather data and to produce in the same times. And finally, lastly, I want to show some experiences about science driven. It's called a web platform called Cortex. When in the last years, before the French election, there is some primary in a white party Republicans, and they decide to observe what people spoke on Twitter, for example. So they gather multiple tweets during the 12 November to the 21 November. It means 10 days of activity with a highest peak during the election day, of course, and the small peak for the last debate of the primary. All the tweets are mostly in French, of course, and they have a daily pattern during the election day. So what they gather, it is all the hashtags we can see. So it is more or less a simple map. This is maybe not the most interesting map. We can see which keywords is directly related to each keywords in this map. But the real interesting map, even if, yes, I know the size is not the best, but this one is most interesting because this map shows the main topics of concern of the linking of two users when they share the same hashtag. When they share the same hashtags, when they are related user to user. If they share the same hashtag, they are related between them. And so on, we can detect community of people behind the different party or person involved. It gives an idea of the strong differences of the topic and the political family involved in this process. And we can see there is, it was in the primary republic, but we can see there is some strong community who are far away from another community. For this one was a French politician who was called Poisson. And it was someone who was like, you know, he don't want two people to get vaccinated. He don't think we get on the moon and things like that. So he have a strong community, but far away from other more classical candidates. And so on. I'm finished. Thank you for your attention. So have you question maybe, or maybe we can talk more freely?
When you go back.
Yes, well?
Stop.
This one?
Yes. No. Ah, no, yes. This is law for the society.
This is a website, if you want. I have the entire screenshot. It is a website who was created specifically I think it worked on Drupal or something like that. And we can show it here. It's so. Okay, it is a website where there is all the consultation of the law. So each title by title, chapter by chapter, and section by section of the law project was hemmed by the government first. They prepared their law project. Then they put on the internet on this website, and they put people to vote on to make argumentation, proposition, or maybe other law creation. And after that, they send the result of this website directly to the government. The government choose which he wants, which he don't want. For example, he wants video game, he don't want decriminalized cryptography.
But you can propose a new law if you can propose a new law.
What?
You can put a new law.
You can propose.
Propose a new law.
Yes.
If the government approve that, then apply to the society, the law that you propose?
On this specific field or another field of law?
Whatever.
You can, of course, you can contact the government and you can send a mail and say, hey, I have an idea. But in 100% of the case, no. If it's not interested on, it will not listen to you. But with this,
You can mail,
of course. As I can say to you, hey, I have a project law. But if I don't listen to you, you can talk all you want. If no one listens to you, it's not interesting.
He's asked, I think, I don't know if I'm correct, but how I hear his question, he's asking, in this system,
yes,
someone can propose a new kind of legislation.
Yes, yes, okay, that's it. That is, yes.
Then he's asking, does it obtains to the whole group? Everybody has to
vote.
Follow that, right? That's what he's asking. I assume that's the case, but he's just verifying. Is that true?
Yes.
That if your idea gets passed and the legislature, whoever it is, votes to agree that okay, we're going to do this, everybody, it applies to everybody.
Only if the government had finally decided to accept it.
Right, right.
But yes, yeah. But yes. And effectively, more people will follow you and vote positively on, and more you will have the luck to get accept, or at least to get light on your subjects and say, hey, we have more than 500 people who want to decriminalizing cryptography. So, what's on? Mm-hmm. And governments have to respond seriously to you to say no, we don't want because blah blah blah, because of blah blah blah, etc. etc. But yes, that's the fact. And this is something really interesting of this project. It was for the moment unique in France, and well, we hope to make again these experiences on other subjects, because for this law, it was specifically dedicated on the internet and numerics projects. And maybe we hope in France we can extend these processes on other fields of subjects. So that's it.
Have you considered the consequences, the negative consequences of these crowd-driven legislation, crowd-driven
populism?
Huh?
Like populism? Populism?
Yeah, not necessarily just populism, but for instance, in the United States, you see how there's this whole question about how people are being their sort of their view or their
drive-in
are being biased or forced in a certain direction or the other direction, and then you end up with this exaggeration of the scores. Obviously, it's
yes.
Not to say this is not a good idea, I'm just looking at the other alternative.
Yes, of course, it depends of which people will give their advice on this website. So mainly, why video game competition was accepted, it's because there is a huge community of gamers of internet. And this is why there is a lot of votes coming from video game. It is the same from the scientific article who were involved in this project and so on. They said, okay, we are scientific and we want this. So let's be together and put this on. But it is related to the community and it's the first experiences. So it needs to be repeated to see how it could be upgraded to reduce this type of effects. But as it is unical, we don't have other point of comparison. That's the fact. Step by step. Maybe you know something similar outside of the France?
I told you yesterday, I'm sorry because I don't believe you about the Euro, you have talked enough, but you remember yesterday I told you, I think there's a very similar thing in Spain made by the municipality of Madrid.
Yes.
And they are having some experiment. I should need to look for the names about something like whatever plaza systems, web system to try to people to discuss, to discuss or whatever. I should need to review my links to try to find if you're interested.
Yes.
But probably the main one is I don't remember the thing, but I can look for the name of the guy. I think
of course.
Soto from Madrid.
Si.
And I told you yesterday too about the OKEFM,
yes.
The Open Knowledge Foundation.
Yes, yes.
Which they keep somewhere. I forgot the name. Which is the common platform. Most of the a lot of platform of open data in government and non-government is used in across the world.
Mm-hmm.
Probably you should.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Two things I need to remember. So open knowledge platforms and how you say the first.
What?
The first one you said, what it was?
The first one was the first.
You said the Open Knowledge Foundation, and just before you talk.
The people of Madrid?
Yeah, the people of Madrid.
And if you are interested, I should do research in my book.
Of course.
For this other system of discussion, of city discussion, to
of course.
Work on laws or whatever.
I'm really interested to get more resources in Spanish language. So, yes, of course, social.
After the talk,
yes,
we
with pleasure. With pleasure.
Do you know that in Taiwan they actually have established a system which is binding for the government legally, like an online democracy platform that is used to show people like different legal proposals, and then they will be able to answer certain questions and figure out in what kind of what place they are in political space. And they can also, I think there is some decision process. So the Taiwanese government is actually doing this to show that they're really democratic in comparison to China, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
But it's pretty interesting. I mean, the platform is called Polis, like POL.IS.
Okay. IS?
IS, like Polis, like,
yeah. Okay, Polis, P-L-A-E-C dot E-S?
Yes.
Okay. And it is related to which resources, you say?
I think it's national level.
Okay.
Legal decisions. I mean, I haven't used it. I know the guy who built it. So yeah, it's open source, the platform, and at least I think it's a big part is open source, and they have some contract now to the Taiwanese government. I don't know if this is directly what you are.
Yes, indirectly. I think it could be yes, indirectly maybe.
Right.
I need to
switch. And then I have to ask you again. So, So what exactly do you see as the relationship between these open data initiatives and the civic engagement in this case? I mean, you mean like citizens are better informed to make like public decisions? Because I mean, they can also have like the data about the pesticides and so on, which is not directly political. I mean, how do you think about the data in political?
The relation between data and political data?
Yes.
Because it was fixed by a legal framework. So all of this data, all of this website was created with how they can give access to the data and how you can reuse them and how you can stay them. It's not exactly opening all of the data, but you have the number of the vote, you have the number of the person who voted for, person who makes the argumentation, person who proposed some new law. And well, it's a first step, I think, from my point of view. I think it's a first step. It's not, it's maybe a lit, it's a mix of the two, in my opinion. And if you put them from the, maybe if we'll see in the future and imagine this process could be extended and upgrade, and after that, you could take the data from the National Assembly where all the text law and all the participation are committed and it is possible to access it on the open data. Maybe we can get a large view of the process of how a law could be created and voted from a social point of view and until the vote of the law. I don't know if I have...
So you want to basically monitor and study the process?
Yes.
It's not your primary concern to establish a process of digital legal framework? Like you're not political in the sense, like you would like to build an online democratic process, but you're more interested in making it transparent.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, that's it.
Okay.
That's the thing. Okay, I hope
yeah,
it could be useful. Thank you, everyone.